Hey everybody, PT here at Casa Gazell in Kingston Springs, Tennessee. Continuing on with house arrest like the rest of us, and bemoaning the fact that the Masters is not going to be played next week, bemoaning the fact that Major League Baseball is not going to start or should have started by now. Got my Cubs hat on, so I'm kind of living vicariously through my hat at the moment. The plus, if there is one, is that this spring here in Middle Tennessee, all the leaves came out early, probably 2.5 to 3 weeks early, including the oak trees, which is unusual. And I don't know if you can see in the background, but the red buds are spectacular. And it's one of those rare springs where the dogwoods bloomed at the same time. And so the colors are lovely and the weather is absolutely lovely. So I'm sitting out here on the porch and was playing a little harmonica. And I'm actually playing today a Seydel Lightning. This is the one with the polished reeds and the stainless steel comb. I haven't had a chance to play it too much. They sent me one right after it debuted at NAMM. I saw it at NAMM and played it for about 30 seconds, but I didn't really, you know, and it wasn't half-valved or anything. So when I got it home, when they sent me one, I half-valved it and set it up the way I like my harmonicas to play. And so I've been kind of fooling around with it today a little bit. It's interesting. It's reminiscent. I don't know how many of you remember Frank Wang, Chambers' brother. He made a series of chromatics for a while that had a solid bell brass comb. Well, this stainless steel comb reminds me of that because it's so heavy. And of course, Joe Felisco made brass combs for a while. And I think Tom Halchek, of course, now does too. But so there's a real weight to it. It's nice. Interestingly enough, even though I haven't played it very much, I have a couple of customers who wanted me to make them one, so I did that. This was a couple weeks ago already, and they wanted it half valved with my valves, and they wanted it set up the way I set up the harmonica, but they wanted to try the polished reeds and the stainless steel comb. So they seem pretty pleased with it, and today, like everybody else, I'm doing things that I'm finding time to do things that I didn't have time to do before. And so I've been playing some harmonica out here in the front porch. And what I've noticed, I've been playing this one in particular, and this is in this is B flat. And what I've noticed about it is that there's a real evenness of tone from the bottom to the top, and a real evenness of response and attack on each note. And that's something that no matter who the manufacturer is or what key, I don't think I've ever really experienced that. You know, maybe guys that do real high-end customizing probably strive for that. You know, I'm sure some of you that have something by Joe Spires, perhaps, or, you know, some Felisco stuff or whoever, there may be that feeling. And mine kind of, when I'm done working on them, they kind of have that. But to be right out of the box and have that response on one blow be the same as 10 blow is pretty unusual in my opinion. So anyway, yeah, I've been sitting here playing it a little bit, and I thought I would play a tune that I did in 2015 on my Madness to the Method project. This is a Benny Golson tune. Let's see if I can play it. It's called I Remember Clifford. Yeah, this is worth trying, folks. In fact, let me build you a Gazell method one. In the meantime, stay home, stay healthy, and let's get through this.